Before you do a routine upgrade of the Pi server, we suggest you do a backup. Now, this is just common sense IT, you know, good practices. We always want to have a good backup just in case, for whatever reason, the upgrade fails. Or if, for example, you would like to go back to the previous version. Obviously, it's not by design, but sometimes we see customers who upgrade, and then there are certain features they were counting on that the behavior changes. And obviously, we try to avoid those, but it's sometimes just a sad fact of development that changes you make to improve may actually end up hurting some customers. So in any event, it's a really good idea to have a good backup. Just to let you know, there is no downgrade procedure. So in fact, when you do have to restore to a previous version, you're basically going to be deleting Pi and then reinstalling it and restoring the backup. So the first step to an upgrade is to do a backup. And we suggest you first stop Pi before you do your upgrade, then do the upgrade, and then start up Pi, and that should work fine. Of course, we say upgrade from the CD. Most people are now downloading Pi from a website, so it's probably not going to be on a physical media that you do this. So let's take a look at this computer. I'll do a quick upgrade. First thing I'd like to do is just make sure that Pi is in fact shut down, and I would do that by going into the Pi/ADM directory and doing a Pi-SRV stop. Do Pi-SRV stop, that should normally stop the Pi system. One of the few times you're going to be stopping it without actually long, aside from when you shut down the operating system. Now, once you're finished doing that, next thing you should do is do a net start command just to verify that everything has in fact shut down. So take a look at what happens when I do this. I do net start. This is a Windows command. And without passing any parameters, the net start has the effect of listing all the services that are currently running. If I scroll up, you can see, ooh, that's interesting, Pi Network Manager. I had just stopped Pi, so why is this still running? Well, in this case, and this is not too unusual to happen, I may have, say, for example, shut down Pi, and then I just launched Process Book briefly to take a look at something on a different server, for example. The effect of starting up a local client is that it will start up Pi Network Manager, and it will start up this, some other things as well, some other Pi. The Pi message subsystem, for example, is sometimes started up. This is just a normal client service, so you don't have to shut that down before backing up or before doing an upgrade. So in any case, at this point, I would like to shut this down, Pi Network Manager. And there's a couple of ways to do this. Probably the most convenient right here would be to use the DOS prompt commands. And let me demonstrate that. I would do a net stop, and then the name of the service, Pi Network Manager. That would work just fine. Now the other things you could do, see if we can demonstrate this. I don't know if you can see, there you go. We can see this now. If we run the services applet within Windows, services.msc, you can also stop PiNet Manager using that service manager. Let me bring this onto the screen here. And if we look at all the Pi-related services, you should find Pi Network Manager, and you should see that it's actually currently started. So we could stop it either way. I could stop Pi Network Manager. Yeah, here we go, Pi Network Manager, it's currently started. I could just stop it like that. Or as I said, I could do it this kind of old-school way from the DOS prompt. Net stop is a command that will normally stop a service. So I'll go ahead and stop Pi Network Manager before I do my upgrade. And as you can see, if I refresh my screen now, there we go, it is now stopped. So at this point, with all the Pi processes stopped, I'm ready to do the upgrade. I'm going to go ahead and close out of these. And as we said in our slides here, again, first step, stop Pi. Second is to go ahead and just actually do the upgrade. Now I'm going to do the upgrade by running my upgrade executable. I tend to, and we've told people this for years for system managers, it's not a bad idea to keep all your installations in one place, just keep them locally. We traditionally have called that Pi source, but that's just kind of a recommendation that we've had within tech support and training for a while. It's certainly nothing official. So I've put my upgrade executable in the PySource directory, and I'm ready to go ahead and upgrade Py. So I'll go ahead and double click on this. You'll notice this is precisely the same file that you would use to do a fresh install. So the install script is smart enough to detect whether this is an upgrade or a new install. Now, while that's unzipping, what I'd like to do is bring up the DOS prompt again and just show you what I'm in fact upgrading. So let me show you. I'm going to type cmd to launch the command window. I'll bring this up onto the screen, and I'll change directories to py/adm. And if you look at py version -v, you can see this is the 3.4.364 version. We're going to upgrade to the 3.6.5 version, .38, I believe. So that's the upgrade that we're involved with at this point right here. Now let's take a look at where our upgrade is. It's still unzipping. There we go. It looks like everything was unzipped successfully. And now the upgrade will proceed. Here we're being advised all these things will be installed or upgraded. And I'll just go ahead and take the defaults for just about everything in here. You'll notice there are very few things really to respond to while doing an upgrade. I'll take the default on that. Of course, good practice is to exit all Windows programs. Now at this point, I'm being reminded about the license file. Now those of you who haven't upgraded for quite a while, since the 3.3 release, I believe, this may be new to you. And if you don't have a license file on your system, you're going to have to contact, as we say right here, we're going to have to contact tech support. A tech support would be glad to supply this. They'll just check your license, make sure you've got the license file. Currently what we're doing is we're basically checking to make sure that you're licensed for those applications that are running. And it's going to go ahead and look for that. If it can't find it, it's going to give you the opportunity to browse for it. And in this case, it doesn't find a license file. So I'm going to go ahead and browse for it and place it in the right directory. Now this shouldn't be a problem for me, because if I switch over to my installed copy of Py, I'll find the licensed file right there. So I'll go up to the root directory, which is where we normally install Py, go into the dat directory, and we'll find the pylicense.dat. So we're being prompted, where is that license file? That's where the license file is in this case. So I'll go ahead and choose next, and now we're ready to answer the rest of the prompts. As we've said during the install, if you're not familiar with your serial number, your actual server number, just put in a 0 there. And I would like this to be used by anybody. And it's going to go ahead and take the default directory, which in this case is where the existing Py server is, which is, you know, I kept it in the original default. And now, just as we have been prompted during the install, you have the choice. Do you want this to be auto-started? Actually, in this case, I'm using this as a demo and a test machine. I don't want this to be started automatically every time I reboot the operating system. But I warn you, don't do this at home. This is, normally you would want Py to be started every time you start the operating system, unless you're doing some kind of a test system or a staging system. So in this case, I'm going to turn that off, but you definitely, in most cases, you would not want to do that on a production system. I'll go ahead and choose next. And at this point, we're being prompted for or reminded about changes to our backup system. Now, we put this kind of a roadblock here just to make sure that everybody understands, everybody upgrading understands, that their current backups will probably fail since we've changed the backup procedure. However, this doesn't mean that you can't do the backups the same way you've always done them. If you don't have this Microsoft Volume Shadow Services, this VSS, then there are mechanisms that you can use. There's options you have for setting it up to do it just the traditional backup that you've always done. So in order to learn more about that, we have to refer you over to a section of the server system management introduction. Let me show you where that is. If you go to our tech support site, and this is just simply techsupport.osisoft.com. If you simply say, let's go to download some user manuals, And in this case, what we're going to be looking for, let's just look for all of the user manuals for the Pi server that have the word system management in it. And this is taking a little bit of time. Okay, there we go. And if I simply switch to, let's go with the Pi 3 Enterprise server, and we're going to look for the file name system management. Actually, you didn't have to choose the product there. And what we should find is this introduction. The introduction to system management is a PDF file. There it is, introduction. And once you download this, well, you'll see something like this. Let me open up the file. Yeah, if you go to section 7.6, there's a section there on setting up automatic backups. So we simply have changed the mechanism. So we do exploit visual or the VSS technology if it does exist. If it's not, we do still support doing backups the way you've always done it. It's just that there are some changes you have to make, and those changes are described here. So what we've asked people to do is just go ahead and acknowledge that there is a new backup, and then you can go read that chapter on how to set the backups up the way you'd like to have them run. And of course, as a good practice, we always warn people, do you have a good backup? And I'll go ahead and say, yes, I do have a good backup here. And at that point, the system should go ahead and start doing the upgrade. This message is telling me that the machine I'm currently upgrading has a 1.2 version of Pi AF, the analysis framework. The 1.3 version is the version that is associated with this particular release. This is the PR1 release. Actually, we have an even more recent one that is just about ready to be released, the Pi AF 2.x. So depending on what version you're upgrading, you may get this message or a slightly different message. Currently, that upgrade to Pi AF is not part of the upgrade of Pi. That is something you can download from our website or contact tech support if you need that shipped to you.